and calmed down yet. It's soon time to bring in the harvest.
Have a look, Sunan.
I ain't in the business of helping you.
Dear man, would you live under Evelyn's boot? For that is where you will be if these supplies reach her castle.
I'd give them over to any man for enough silver. I've a livelihood to keep.
Okay.
Before I was caged, and I will again. It's for the good of your Shire.
You've lost your senses.
What's the noise about?
She's trying to rob me. I warn you, soldiers are coming to escort me any minute.
This merchant is taking supplies to the castle. Oil for boiling, arrows, shields, rations. I offered to buy them, but he refuses.
I don't sell on a future promise of profit. Edwin's a valuable customer.
Then I'll make you a new offer. Here's more than enough coin, friend.
Boy, Jesus, you're a better customer than your needling partner.
We can use these oil jars to surprise the soldiers.
I see visions of burning men, the screams of soldiers aflame. If we place the oil and supplies near the hay along the road, it will burn like hellfire when the soldiers arrive.
Take position on that bluff and watch for the soldiers, would you?
You'll hear me howl as the men approach.
Best not to draw attention here. What was that?
My howl. Edwin's men approach.
Prepare yourself! The soldiers are close. That overhanging branch is a good vantage for a first strike.
God, what a summer day named Montpenya, Fandian.
Let's go. brother.
That's the last of them. Edwin will be waiting for aid that never comes. Something wrong?
No. No, quite the opposite. At Sancte Albanes, your brother claimed kinship with the gods. Is it true? Is he descended from the Archon's children? The Issu?
Not to be blunt, Fulke, but only half of what you say ever makes any sense to me.
Forgive me. I often presume too much of my audience. Men who fear damnation, when ignorance is the greatest of all evils.
Ignorance of what?
What a perfect sentence. I'll ask more simply. Could your brother be descended of the god, or could he be a god himself?
How is that possible? You don't believe such a thing yourself, do you?
Not elusive self-begotten light who reigns over all, but a lesser god. Imperfect and given to temptation.
Sigurd is only a man, the son of a king and my brother. He may think highly of himself, but he's no god.
Yet it's possible his line of kings was fathered by a god, in ages past.
We haven't time for these fantasies, Fulke. It's time I regroup with Giedrich to see how his assault preparations are coming along.
Godspeed, Eivor. I will stay here to pray for the souls of the dead before I join you.
guide me. Be my eyes.
There's Eivor!
We're with you, Eivor!
Those castle walls won't be thick enough to stop
us! What above?
Heathrich.
Eivor, have you dealt Eadwin a few bruising blows?
I have. She'll feel the pain soon enough.
Excellent. My men are itching to attack the fortress, but we'd be fools to force it now.
Why is that?
On account of Eadwin's got too many traps and defenses. Her springalds cut us to bloody stumps before they poured boiling oil upon us like a summer tempest.
Keep the men at the ready. I'll slip in alone and see what I can do about these defenses.
By my joints and ankles, you're a tough one.
They rule the waterways.
Eivor! Giedrich! And victory!
Castle Keep looks impregnable. That will be Eadwin's last stand. Go, Sunan. Right, I'm in. Thank you.
apoptosis. Scientific.
My duty, although the monk's a great believer in the wax of bees,
he was no fool.
Wax supply follows.
Thank you.
more to be done, but this should be enough to launch the assault. Now it's down to Giedrich to lead his men.
Say we wait. There's too much riding on this.
I am Sigurd Jarl, Lord of East Mercia, and I say we fight now. Is it done?
It is.
And have you laid your poles of hazel and composed your poems for this coming victory?
I'm here to speak with Giedrich.
Go on then. Your master awaits.
Still dreaming of your precious stone.
It is not dreams that led me here, Eivor. I've had visions, prophecies from the gods.
Visions.
I'll sacrifice to Tyr this day, the Lord of Justice, the harbinger of flawless victory.
Sigurd, what prophecies?
Are we ready to assault the castle, Eivor? The signs importance read well.
We are ready. Give the command.
Good. And let's be quick about it. My scouts tell me a force of King Alfred's men is on the march. Let's end this before that flap-mouthed pudding has a chance to hit back.